Namaskar. Thank you so much for tuning in to Desi Plaza TV. I'm your host Karishma Himmat Singhani. Today we have a very special team of a very special organization called Upasana. Upasana is an organization which represents the North Indian community here in DFW Metroplex. And Upasana is an organization that has been here in the Metroplex working for the community and bringing the community together through their works, events, and various seminars and programs. Today we have the entire team of Upasana here talking about Upasana and their upcoming day called Upasana Day on 8th of April. To begin with, I would like to welcome the entire team here on Desi Plaza TV studio, and I would like to introduce the president of Upasana here sitting next to me on my right, Rohit Singh. Thank you so much, Rohit Singh, for coming here, and you're most welcome here in Desi Plaza TV. I would like to begin, first of all, welcome, and then I would like to ask you, tell our viewers more about your organization, that is Upasana.
Sure. Thank you, Karishma ji. Thank you, Desi Plaza, for giving us this opportunity. And as you said, Upasana is one of the biggest organizations in North America representing Hindi-speaking people from Indian states. And it's a young organization. It's a growing organization. We do a lot of activities around the year. We do focus our things on kids, parents, everybody. Basically, Upasana has been divided into three sub-categories, which are Upasana Sangeet Samiti, Upasana Kala Samiti, and Upasana Scholar Development Committee, which, as by name you can see, Scholar Development Committee is focusing on kids, developing them from youth and making sure that they achieve what they want, and the parents are also involved in that. Sangeet Samiti is a place where you can groom your talent. If somebody is talented in or wants to learn music, singing, that's the place you should go for. Everything is free, and there are teachers who will guide you all along the way. Upasana Kala Samiti, if anybody is interested in dances, sports, that's the place where the kids will go and enjoy different activities. I have my whole team here. I will introduce Anjani Kumar on my right, extreme right, is the current Vice President Finance. Sanjeev Agarwal ji heads the USS Upasana Sangeet Samiti. On my left, Praveen Gupta ji is current treasurer. Ajay Gupta ji is past secretary, and Preetam Kumar ji is VP Public Relations. Thank you.
So I would like to ask, when did Upasana founded here in DFW chapter? You said Upasana is a North American, is entire North American your organization is working. I would like to ask, you know, how big is the organization, how many chapters do you have, and when it was founded?
So Upasana, as I said, is a young organization. It was founded in 2013, uh-huh. And we have been growing since then in Dallas Metroplex. And right now we are working in Raleigh, in Houston, in Canada to open up new chapters. So as you can see, in New Jersey and even San Francisco, we have got queries, mm-hmm. people asking what it is about and how we can engage with yourself. So it's a growing organization, as I said.
Mm-hmm. And it is basically focusing in the North Indian community in USA?
Yes, as you have seen, there are a lot of organizations from in India representing people from different areas, but we haven't found anything which represents North Americans as a total. Okay. So this is anybody who speaks Hindi language is most welcome to be part of. Anybody from India, Indian subcontinent, mm-hmm. They are most welcome to join it.
So हिंदी भाषा जिसका जिसको भी ज्ञान है और हिंदी भाषी लोगों के साथ वो मिंगल होना चाहता है डैलस फोर्ट वर्थ चैप्टर में उपासना कैन बी अ ग्रेट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन और ज़रूरी नहीं है क्योंकि हिंदी हमारी भारत में राष्ट्रभाषा है तो हिंदी बोलने वाले साउथ में भी हैं और नॉर्थ में भी हैं ईस्ट में भी हैं वेस्ट में भी हैं तो ये एक बहुत अच्छी बात कही आपने कि भाषा की आपने बात जोड़ी उपासना के साथ तो अब तक उपासना की क्या क्या इवेंट्स आपने किए हैं एज यू सेड दिस इज़ अ यंग ऑर्गेनाइजेशन 2013 सो हाउ इट इज़ शेपिंग अप एंड व्हाट आर योर फ्यूचर गोल्स फॉर द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन
Well, I wouldn't want to take all the time. I would have my committee people also respond. So yeah. Maybe Praveen Gupta ji can add what's the upcoming event.
Upasana does like multiple events, mm-hmm. all throughout the year. Uh-huh. To begin with, you know, we start with Holi. Uh-huh. It's okay. A big festival of Indians. And, you know, we celebrate in a big way. We uh-huh. invite all the families. and we play with colors.
Uh-huh.
And then we is Upasana day that we celebrate.
Okay.
Like this is the first time we are doing it.
Uh-huh.
But it is going to be a grand day celebration.
Okay.
And it's an all day celebration. And moreover, it is a free event, totally free. Nobody has to buy any tickets or anything.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas, you know, they can enjoy a Bollywood concert.
Mm-hmm.
We have invited some Bollywood stars.
Okay.
And they'll be performing in the evening. And we have all day activities.
Uh-huh.
You know, that'll be, I mean, for everybody.
So, yeah. Also, I would like to, when Rohit Singh was talking about the different programs in Upasana, when was the scholarships? So,
yeah.
Would you like to talk about that scholarship program in your organization?
Yeah, sure, Karishma ji. I mean, Upasana, as part of the USDC,
mm-hmm.
Upasana Scholarship Development Committee, we are trying to promote and bring all the young kids
mm-hmm.
and see how we can encourage them. So,
mm-hmm.
as part of that, our mission. We are trying to, we came up with a different scholarship where they can participate and focus on Indian culture. So one thing that we very specifically focus on is how can we get our kids to learn more about Indian culture, put some emphasis, write some essays,
mm-hmm.
and based on that, we come up with a criteria on,
mm-hmm.
on judging first, second, and third prize and give it to our kids. So that way they are more encouraged and they are more their knowledge on the Indian culture and more specifically North Indian culture increases and enhances.
Mm-hmm. So when we talk about culture, what all do we cover in culture? Could be literature, could be more cultural programs like that. So what all do you include in when you say cultural activity?
So cultural, it includes multiple aspects, and
uh-huh.
I will let Sanjeev Agarwal ji speak on that part.
जी करिश्मा जी, उपासना उत्तरीय प्रदेश अंतर्राष्ट्रीय समिति ऑफ नॉर्थ अमेरिका, तो जैसा नाम में ही है
जी
उत्तरीय प्रदेश, तो पहले मैं ये एम्फसाइज करना चाहता हूँ, जैसे मेरे कोलीग्स ने भी बताया
जी,
सबसे बड़ी पहली बात है कि ये उत्तर प्रदेश नहीं है, उत्तरीय प्रदेश है
जी,
तो सारे नॉर्थ इंडियन स्टेट्स, यूपी, बिहार, बंगाल, राजस्थान, पंजाब और यहाँ तक कि
जम्मू कश्मीर, उत्तरांचल, हिमाचल,
इधर साउथ में मध्य प्रदेश, महाराष्ट्र, सारे लोग हम लोग से जुड़े हुए हैं ऑलरेडी हमारी संस्था में, या ऑल द वे इवन साउथ के बहुत सारे लोग जुड़े हुए हैं, क्योंकि जैसा रोहित सिंह जी ने कहा,
हिंदी
उत्तरीय प्रदेश होते हुए, हिंदी भाषी होते हुए, कहीं के भी हों हमारी संस्था से जुड़े हुए हैं। और इस संस्था में केवल आपने जैसे भाषा के बारे में एम्फसाइज किया, वो बड़ी अच्छी बात है, मगर इसके साथ साथ कल्चर भी चलता है। आपने पूछा कल्चर में क्या करते हैं, तो हम लोग सारे त्योहार भी मनाते हैं। जैसे एक बात मकर संक्रांति का मैं एग्जांपल देता हूँ, अब कितने लोग यहाँ पे होंगे जो कि मकर संक्रांति मनाते हैं, मगर हमारी उपासना समिति मकर संक्रांति तक मनाती है।
अच्छा।
तो ये सब बड़ी यूनिक बातें हमारी उपासना समिति में।
uh-huh.
और मैं ये एम्फसाइज करना चाहता हूँ कि अगर आप अपना देश याद करते हैं, बच्चों को कल्चर सिखाना चाहते हैं, छोटे छोटे त्योहार जो हम लोग इंडिया में मनाते थे उनके बारे में एक्सपोजर देना चाहते हैं, तो दिस इज द समिति की आप ज्वाइन करिए, हमारे साथ जुड़िए और हम लोग ये सब मिलके मनाएंगे।
तो मैं अपने दर्शकों की सुविधा के लिए आपसे पूछना चाहूंगी कि कोई ऐसी वेबसाइट है आपकी, ऐसा फोन नंबर है, कोई कॉन्टेक्ट है जहाँ पे जाके लोग उपासना के बारे में और ज्यादा जान पाए?
बिल्कुल, upasana.org, बहुत सिंपल सा याद रखने में, वहाँ पे सारे फोन नंबर्स हैं, यहाँ पे जितने हम सब लोग बैठे हैं सबके फोन नंबर्स वहाँ पे हाजिर हैं, आप किसी को भी कॉल करिए, आपका बड़ा स्वागत करेंगे हम लोग
जी। सो जब रोहित सिंह जी मेंशन कर रहे थे कला समिति और संगीत समिति, तो इन दोनों समितियों में क्या अंतर है और किस तरह से ये दोनों समितियाँ अलग अलग काम करती हैं
जी,
आप हमें बताना चाहेंगे? Would you like to share your thoughts on this?
Sure. So, Upasana Sangeet Samiti, the main focus is that we promote the classical music among the people here in the United States. I'm myself, since the beginning, very much interested towards learning singing, mm-hmm. piano, guitars.
Mm-hmm.
But somehow I never got a chance.
Correct.
I have my own unique story. I don't have that chance so far, but I started based on the recommendation we got from Upasana, I started learning music, singing, piano and various things. So, of course, the classical music is the core element in the Upasana Sangeet Samiti. In Upasana Kala Samiti, it's all about the culture, promoting, like we have been talking about the Holi, Diwali and various such events. So we are organizing all these functions, all these festivals in a big way. We are inviting all people from different parts, not necessarily Hindi speaking, but it is open for all. So we are trying to promote culture. We are trying to ensure that our children, they are totally accustomed to what is our root. So that is very important for us.
So Praveenji, you being the treasurer for this particular organization, I would like to ask, how does the organization run? You say it's free for all, you're providing all the facilities. So there has to be some kind of arrangement. That how does it run through membership fee, sponsorship? How does it work?
It is mainly run by the sponsorship. We have like great sponsors that contribute towards like scholarship that we provide, and even for the event, like for all expenses.
Correct.
You know, we have like more than maybe 20-25 sponsors that that support us. And during the year, of course, with all membership fees and we other events. You know, we contribute sometimes, you know, we all sponsor a few things out of it, and that's how we do.
Okay. So, I would like to ask about Upasana Day now, which is coming up. This is supposedly your first Upasana Day that you're organizing. It's a big event, pretty big, and the entire day event is happening on 8th of April. मैं आपकी फ्लायर में भी चेक कर रही थी कि यू नो देर आर स्कॉलरशिप्स देर आर प्राइजेस एंड देन देर इज अ कॉन्सर्ट सो आई वुड लाइक टू नो मोर अबाउट उपासना डे व्हाट ऑल इज हैपनिंग ऑन उपासना डे
श्योर उपासना डे एज यू सेड इट्स अ होल डे इवेंट वी यूज्ड टू डू डिफरेंट इवेंट्स ऑल अक्रॉस द ईयर सो वी थॉट ओके लेट्स क्लब इट टुगेदर एंड हैव पीपल कम एंड गेट एन अट्रैक्शन देयर सो उपासना डे वी कम अप विद द आइडिया And Upasana Day will be, as you said, it's a free event, so no charges for, but we always request people to go and register on our website for quiz or for scholarship. Scholarship deadline is coming up, it's March 31st, and all the details are there, the forms, what they have to do, but to give you an idea of what Upasana Day, it will start with a quiz, which is for sixth graders and above. And which carry prizes around $1,000.
Okay.
And the scholarship what we are talking about is $4,000 for high school kids. So somebody who is going to college, and it's a big amount for anybody going to college. And then we have, as most of us Indian people, we don't pay much attention about our what's going to happen about our will and estates. So we, most of us don't have will. So we came up with an idea. We have a attorney coming in who will talk about will and estate planning, how it's going to help you even on taxes and everything. So it's
so basically different kind of workshops are also happening during the Upasana Day. So let's park this thought, and when we come back after a small break, we talk more about Upasana Day and what all is happening on Upasana Day. Please stay tuned. You're with Karishma on Desi Plaza TV.